So here are players. They've only met once before, that was at the home tournament of Corvee Labar. The Indian pair won that very comfortably, not too long ago as well, that one, towards the end of last year. Well, this is going to be a big ask, perhaps, from the French pair. Lucas Corvee is 30 years of age, tall man at 1.9, currently 36th in the world, but he has hit a high of 29. That was not too long ago, July of last year. Bonne Labar, 34, also very tall at 191. Yes, big one here. He's a former European junior champion bronze medalist, Lucas Corvee. Great result though to beat Kim Won Ho and Nasung Ung Seung in just under an hour. So discount them at your peril. They have not won on the world tour yet. More on that in a while. Rankireddy is 23 from South Indian bastion of badminton Hyderabad. They are number two in the world. They have been former world number one. So that was just a few months ago. That was big news as well when that first happened. Chirag Shetty, 26 from the commercial capital Mumbai. 186 centimeters. We've got four very tall players, haven't we? And they are world champion bronze medalist from 2022. Of course, that victorious Thomas Cup team they were part of in Bangkok in 2022 when they won it. Historic. They beat Fikri and Molana yesterday on this court. Played very well. They are the reigning Commonwealth Games champions. Emi Sakamoto, the umpire from Japan. And Fadil Syed from Mauritius is the service judge. Also got a silver in the 2018 Commonwealth Games. And on the World Tour, they have won seven titles. They've been runner-up three times. The runner-up, in fact, recently in the China Masters, it's Super Sub 50. And they won the Korea Open, the Indonesia Open, and the Swiss Open last year. So they are certainly pretty in form overall. Have last year got to the semi-finals of this tournament, obviously looking to go one better.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Lucas Corvee and Ronan Labar, France. And on my left, Katoik Sailaj Rankireddy and Chirag Shetty, India. Ronald Labar to serve to Sattwick Silas Rankireddy. Labar, play.
First point on the board for the Indian pair.
Service over.
Labar and Corvee getting together in May of 2021. Played that much together, but overall their record on the World Tour, 15 wins, 33 losses.
That's over. One, all.
That's on the World Tour, by the way, getting together. But, they played together once.
Service for the ball. Two high.
Spanish international.
Service over. 2-1.
And then got back together in May of 2021 before moving on to the World Tour a little bit later on.
Sorry. 3-1.
French pair last year in the World Tour won 8 matches and lost 18. Had 7 straight first round exits.
Four, one.
Their best performance last year were a couple of quarterfinals on the World Tour. That was at the Orleans Masters, home tournament as such, and at the US Open. Both times they lost to the same opponents by a strange quirk, Chen Boyang and Liu Yi of China. Both times, actually, they outranked the Chinese pair as well, which I thought was quite interesting. Of course, they are...
5-1.
French pair here looking to get into the home Olympics. It's a big moment for them in Paris. Just trying to push that one for there.
1.
Finding it tough yet. Very quick points. 2 minutes, 7 Bona, points on board.
Fourth. 7-1.
Compare that with the Indians last year, their record. Overall, very decent one, very good one, in fact.
8-1.
It's a procession of points for the Indians right now. Seven points in a row. Going very nicely for Rankireddy and Shetty.
9-1.
Long time either.
fault ball. Too high.
Oh, too high. First one I've seen in the
That's
last
over.
Day and a half.
2-10.
They'll take that right now. French, I'll take anything at the moment, the way this is going. We go into the interval with very much in favour of Rankireddy and Shetty. They're cruising at the moment, 11-2 in game one. So far,
3-12.
Got to put a run on, really. French pair. First time they've had consecutive points.
Over 13-4.
Shetty, without hesitation,
14-4.
Finishes that off. Interval, it's 3-3 after the break, which is pretty decent overall, you have to say, given the context of this match thus far. Much better. Where was this earlier, you wonder? Well, this is best period. This match up till now from the French pair. Only trailing by six now, given that it was far, far worse earlier on. It was 10 points
Nine,
at one stage.
14.
And this is a 5-point run at the moment. The interval when they were 11-2 down, everyone, 8-3 they're leading. This is really quite impressive from the French pair. 3 points in it. There was a 10-point lead that they have really done so well to whittle down. Corvee and Labar.
Oh.
Finally, that run comes to an end. After very important 7 points.
Service over.
Certainly made this a lot closer.
15-11.
Trying to put a run of their own. The Indians. Rankireddy and Shetty, there might be a fight back that would cause some problems.
'19-11.
They have indeed managed to put their own run on to quickly blunt that resistance. 5 in a row here.
Game point 11.
Still a whopping 9 game points.
Four,
So the Indians win this after an incredible start,
first
really.
Saw
them go 12-2 up at one stage, but you've got to give much credit to the French pair who bounced back and, in fact, looked really good. Only just lost in the second half of that first of the first game. And
we are getting it here. I feel the focus is there when
we
are serving.
Let's hear in So, again, just credit back to the French there, because whilst they got thrashed overall, they really did quite well in the second half of that first game and only lost it 10-11. Well, I should say 10-9, excuse me.
2-0.
See how the second one pans out. Will the Indians be aggressive again at the start, which they were?
Service over. 1-2.
Slide across. They're saying there was a fault there.
No.
It hit. It felt. It hit the racket.
Sorry, I didn't. I didn't see it. I didn't see. Sorry. I didn't see. I didn't see. Sorry. Sorry. I didn't see it.
Well, it was not seen, unfortunately.
Three.
There's no other recourse of action here. Let's have a look. It's hard to tell, isn't it? Probably Labar actually in front for the first time in this match, and they extend that lead.
4-2. challenges. Hold out.
Challenge here from Shetty. They quite expected this. It is out.
Challenge
not going their way necessarily anymore. Interesting how it's panning out.
5-2. Play.
Well, you've got to say, the French have really bounced back quite nicely. On a run of 5 points at the moment. 6 points, actually. We'll love two down.
Now, that is big. Challenges.
Challenge, they might have no more challenges here. I thought that was out as well. My initial reaction. I think this one has probably got a very good chance of overturning the decision. No, it's not. Wow, I was very wrong. That was clearly it.
Challenge unsuccessful.
Well, well.
No challenges remaining. 7-2. Play.
This is now turning the other way around. We saw the Indians dominate the first game, and now it's the French pair.
8-2.
Remember, we went into the interval at 11-2 to Rankireddy and Shetty. The way this is going, it's Corvee and Labar who may have that sort of lead at the break. They're putting these away, they're snapping them.
Nine,
they're not being troubled
two.
At all. Well, that is, this is generally regarded as the preferred end.
Three,
anyway.
Nine.
But we've had all straight games wins here. So far today, according to the last three games, anyway, the last three matches, so I'm going to use that. Well, this is very, very good. Corvee and Labar. A little slice of luck there, that's got to be frustrating for Corvee. Excellent second game so far for Corvee and Labar. What a turnaround. They are 11-4 up, having lost the first game convincingly. But it's been brilliant from them after a poor first game.
Hold to 20 seconds.
Ready with the rackets, okay? Yeah. When we hit from the backboard, we're ready.
Play
when we catch it, and then we're ready again. Okay?
They've won 20 of the last 34 points. So just about 65% or so of the points have gone their way, the French pair. And now the Indians going to give themselves a fair bit of work to do. Last year they played six matches in the round, the second round, and won two of them. Now looking to put a run of their own.
11 meetings.
First point since it's in their favour. Let's see if the Indians can put on a similar sort of comeback post-interval like the French did in the first game. Together as a pair, Labar and Corvee have been in just 12 second round matches. They have only won three of them. This would be something tremendous. So just a little long.
Service over.
It's for the Indians.
7-13.
In the second round last year, they played nine matches, won six, lost three. Yeah, a little bit surprising overall. And in their careers in terms of second round matches. As a pair, which by the way is reduced to 5 points. Matches in the second round. They've won 32 and lost 19. Rankireddy and Shetty. This is much, much better. This really is a role reverse, isn't it? Because the team that dominated before the interval has then been pinned back by the team that's trailing. It was 4-11 at the break in the second game. It's 5-2 in favour of Rankireddy and Shetty since then. Need to continue this run. It was around this sort of time when it got close, really close. in the last game. It was 14-11. It was as close as it got, 3 points before the Indians embarked upon a big run. Seven in a row. Well, this would be impressive.
11-13.
You've got to give a lot of credit to the Indians because they
40.
Had to dig a little deep here. It's a good test for them, really. The French pair will be kicking themselves a little because it's 8-11 so far in favor of the Indians since the interval. We've got used to this side now. Just 1 point in it.
30, 40.
Second time that's happened to the Indians in this match.
Service over. 15-13. No, use your foot. Use your foot. Okay, back on court. Service over, 14-15.
Now, again, within a point of their opponents, can they just draw level? Finish this off. Rankireddy and Shetty never lost to French opposition in 5 matches. In fact, they've only dropped a game once. Against the Popov 16, brothers, that was 14. In the French Open 2022. Labar and Corvee still maintaining that lead somehow. Again, within a point.
Over.
They've never beaten an Indian pair, only lost 15, twice before.
16.
But, one of those pairs was Rankireddy and Shetty. First time they've drawn level in this second game since it was 2-2. Big moment here. Remember how big that gap was. Gone for the flick serve. Can they take the lead? Yes, they can. Finally in front.
17, 16.
Well, that's got to be pretty disheartening overall.
Play.
12 of the last 18 points have gone in the way of Rankireddy and Shetty. 67% of the points.
Part.
And now you feel, of course, they will just surge ahead that experience 16. And pedigree that they have. And in fairness, it's a big ask, isn't it? To be playing a pair this highly ranked for Corvee and Labar. This is their eighth meeting of a top five pair in the world, and they've never won. In fact, they've never even won a game, let alone a match against a top five pair.
17, 18.
So this is not going to be easy. But they are only just trailing by a point.
Thank you. I go for it. I change it.
Still think they can come out with this a lot of credit. Oh, he stepped in there, a little bit of a interception from Chirag Shetty,
19,
right
17.
To the back of the court. Nicely done by Chirag Shetty.
Match point 17.
Still got two match points here. Shetty and Rankireddy.
Okay.
And it's done. A real big scare here for the Indians in the second game. You've got to give much credit to the Frenchman who really, from the interval of the first game, were much, much better. That's really, I guess you could say, where they lost the match, in that first part of game one.
Match
they
one
had a big lead in the second game,
7 points,
but they just couldn't hold on. And that's credit to the Indians,
18.
Who won 14 of the next 21 points. So Satvik Sairaj, Rankireddy, Chirag Shetty, these second seeds from India have beaten the French pair of Luca Corvee and Ronan Labar in straight games, 21-11, 21-18. So let's remind you, tomorrow we've got plenty of action. It's split into two sessions on day four. Session one starts at 9, and then we're going to stop at about 1. Three matches will be played, and then five matches in session two. That will start at 3 p.m. So remember, tomorrow a little bit different from all the other days. For now, though, we'll say goodbye for our live coverage here at the HSBC BWF Malaysia Open. We will see you tomorrow.